Aloha Cacao. Today, we will be reviewing cage construction. Cages are installed immediately after planting cacao trees. The cages protect the young cacao from Chinese rose beetle, herbicide damage, and exposure to sun and wind. In addition, the cage promotes good tree architecture, setting up your orchard for a lifetime of success. Before we begin construction, you will need to gather the following items: welded wire fencing or hog wire fencing, T-post or stake, shade cloth at 50% or less shade or plastic sheeting, garden ribbon or rebar wire, a clamp, 6 to 8 inch ground staples, a wire cutter, J-clip tool and J-clips or zip ties, marker, measuring tape. Use of plastic coverings on cages provides a protective barrier when herbicides are sprayed outside the cage. Both plastic and shade cloth are recommended coverings for cacao cages. Measure and mark the height of plastic or shade cloth at 38 to 40 inches. Then, measure and mark the width at 32 inches. Cut the material in straight lines with a pair of scissors. Now it's time to measure and cut the fencing. Mark and cut at 30 inches. The fencing will naturally be 36 inches tall. When cutting the fence, be mindful of sharp edges. For ease and speed, the J-clips are used to secure the ends of the cage, as well as to attach the shade cloth or plastic. It works by bending a metal clip into a circle. Secure the plastic to the cage with J-clips. Fold the plastic over the top of the cage and secure it with a J-clip. Use J-clips along the overlapping seam of the plastic to secure. If desired, zip ties can be used instead. Using shade cloth follows the same general principles as using plastic. The only difference is the material. Measure and cut your shade cloth to the same dimensions: 38 to 40 inches wide, 36 inches tall. Measure and cut your fencing. Pay close attention to sharp edges. Secure the ends of the fencing with J-clips. Fasten the cloth to the cage with the J-clips. You can use a clamp as a third hand to hold the material to the top of the cage when working alone. Cages should be produced and stockpiled before planting day. Cages need to be secured to the ground in the field. In windy conditions, 2 T-posts can be used to reliably hold the cage in place. Use a post hole driver to install your posts. Hearing protection is advised. Gently place the cage over the cacao. Make sure the cage sits equidistant around the tree. Zip ties can be used to hold the cage to the stake. Reusable zip ties are preferred as they conserve resources and can be reused for planting your next block. Maintenance of the trees involves weeding and feeding. The trees need to be accessible by removing the cages, then hand weed or hoe as necessary. Replace and secure the cage after completion of weeding. Alternatively, the use of hog wire enables hand weeding through the cage. To hand weed through the cage, you must use hog wire, as it has variable size openings and you can place the large openings on the ground. Weeding should be done as necessary, and make sure to regularly visit your new plantings to get a good idea of the tree's needs. Mahalo nui loa, and happy planting.